I have discussed extreme values of trigonometric functions, maximum and minimum values or range of trigonometric functions. I have discussed about suppose A sine X. Yes. B cos X plus C. Suppose if an expression is of the form A sin X plus B cos X plus C. Minimum value equals to, as I told the formula, C minus root of A square plus B square. Maximum value root of A square plus B square. Right? Or if he asks the range, range means minimum value to maximum value. C minus root of A square plus B square, comma C plus root of A square plus B square. This is minimum value, maximum value. That means this expression lies between this and this. Now look at here, while applying this formula, before sin x, A will be there. Before sin, A will be there. Before cos, B will be there. Constant, which does not contain any sin x, cos x, that is C. And this angle must be same. If x is, if any angle is there here, the same angle must be there here. Whatever the angles are there, they must be same for applying this formula. These angles must be same. Here, inside sin x and cos x, same angle must be present. Apply this formula when same angle is there. Suppose take examples for this one. This is the main thing in this chapter. Find minimum and maximum values of, suppose take the example number one. Twelve sine x plus 5 cos x plus 10, let us say. This is the one. 12 sin x plus 5 cos x plus 10. So this is a form A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Just whenever same angle you observe, same angle is there. That means A is 12. Apply the formula. B is 5. C is 10. So minimum value is nothing but C. Just write the formula. Yesterday I told how I have derived C minus root of A square. I have told with an example. Root of 12 square. That means 144 plus 25. That means 10 minus 13. Root of 169. So minimum value is minus 3. Maximum value is C plus root of A square plus B square. That means 10 plus root of 144 plus 25. So 10 plus 13. That means 23. So therefore, minimum value of this one is minus 3. Maximum value is 23. Just whenever the angle is same, just apply the formula. Suppose in some cases he asks the range. Range is nothing but minimum to maximum. Minimum to maximum. That means this expression, this means that range is minus 3 to 23 means always this lies between like this. Whatever the given expression is there. Plus 10 less than or equals to 23. If you substitute any angle in place of x, this value whatever you will get, that will lie between minus 3 and 23. Meaning means it will always lie between minus 3 and 23. Like that, direct form is there, this one. Suppose let us take another example. If directly same angle is there, suppose take an example. Always x will not be there. Suppose I am taking an example. 3 cos 2x. Always x will not be there. Look at this angle is 2x. This angle is 2x. They must be same. Whatever the angle may be, they must be same. Not necessarily that always x will be there. In some cases, different angle will be there. But they must be same. Now a equal to 2. B equal to minus 3. Therefore, C equal to 0. If constant is not there, put that C equal to 0. Look at C minus formula is root of A square plus B square. That means minimum value is minus root 30. If constant is not there, take 0. 4 plus, that means maximum value is root 13. Like that, same will be there, but angle 2x. In some cases, angle will be different, but they must be same. Here x, here 2x means, don't write the formula. Here, whatever the angle is there inside sin x, that angle must be there inside cos x. Here, constant is what? 0. Right? In out of A, B, C, in some problems, some constants may be 0. In some cases, A will be 0. In some cases, B will be 0. In some cases, C will be 0. Like that. Suppose, for example, another problem. 4 plus 5 cos x. Let us say. 4 plus 5 cos x. Now, sin x term is not there. You write 0 into sin x plus 5 into cos x plus 4. That means here A equal to 0, B equal to 5, C equal to 4. Now, after getting A and B, it will be easy only. So, minimum value is nothing but C minus root of A square plus B square. That means this is nothing but 4 minus 5. Minimum value is what? Minus 1. Maximum value is nothing but 4 plus root of 0 plus 25. 4 plus 5, that is 9. That is 9. Therefore, minimum value for this is minus 1. Maximum value for this is what? 9. Like that, in some cases, sign will be missing, cos will be missing, and constant will be missing. In that case, you take that equal to 0. So, these are direct forms. Directly, the given expression is of the form A sin x plus B cos x plus C. So, directly, if it is given, directly. Otherwise, the given expression, by using your formula and all the things, you have to convert into A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Right? In transformations, multiple angles, formulas are there. always whenever he is asking to find out maximum and minimum values, by simplifying the given one, always convert into a sin x plus b cos x plus c. Suppose take an example where indirect will be there. Look at, given that if a less than or equals to 5 cos theta plus 3 cos theta minus pi by 3 plus 8. It is given like this, less than or equals to b. Find a comma b. Find a comma b. He is asking like this means this is minimum value, this is maximum value. Now look at here, if you take this expression, plus 8. Now this is not in direct form. Here cos is there, theta is there, theta minus pi by 3 is there. First convert it. So either if same angle theta must be there, that means you know cos of a minus b. Cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. This, now convert this, 5 cos theta, this is 1 by 2, 3 into 1 by 2, 3 by 2 cos theta, right? So now 3 into the sin pi by 3 is what? Root 3 by 2, that means 3 root 3 by 2 sin theta plus 8. Now arrange it, 5 plus 3 by 2. 5 plus 3 by 2 cos theta plus 3 root 3 by 2 sin theta plus 8. Now this is 3 root 3 by 2 sin theta, first sin, and then if you take the LCM, 13 by 2 cos theta plus 8. Now if you look at a sin theta plus b sin theta plus c, same angle, look at here same angle, here same angle. Now it is in that form, a sin x plus b cos x plus c. A is root 3, 3 root 3 by 2, b is 13 by 2, c is 8. Now you can apply the rule, minimum value equal to c minus root of, so root of a square means this whole square means 27 by 4 plus b square means 169 by 4. 8 minus root of 196 divided by 4. 196 divided by 4. Root of 196 is nothing but 14 divided by 2. 2 ones, 2 sevens. That means 8 minus 7. Minimum value is what? 1. So just this given expression, after simplifying, after writing cos of a minus b, you convert into the form a sin x plus b cos x plus c. Then if it is in this form, a, b, c, and then formula. So getting into that form is important. So maximum, what is the answer? Maximum is c plus, just plus will be there. 8 plus root of, everything same. That means 8 plus root of 196 by 4. 8 plus 14 by 2. So 50. Now what is A? A is nothing but minimum value. A is nothing but 1. B is nothing but maximum value. Like that indirectly will be given. By using our prior knowledge of all the formulae, what you have to do is, you convert this expression such that it is of form A sin X, A sin of some angle plus B sin of the same angle plus C. Then you can write the formula. Most of the problems will be converted to this model. Now whatever the syllabus you have, most of the expressions given will be converted to this form. So like that, these are indirect models. Suppose, take another example. So while finding maximum and minimum values, suppose square is there, I have told how to eliminate. Sin square A is nothing but I told 1 minus cos double angle divided by 2. This is how to write whenever sin square will come. In this chapter, whenever sin square is there, you convert by writing 1 plus cos 2A by 2. 1 plus cos 2A by 2. Whenever square is there, you have to eliminate that. Look at, suppose for example, question is given like this. 5 sin square x plus 3 cos square x minus 2. You have to find maximum and minimum values. Now, in the problems are, whatever the expression I will give, find maximum and minimum values. Suppose, look at this one. This is not directly of the form A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Immediately square, you eliminate. This is nothing but 1 minus cos 2x by 2 plus 3 into 1 plus. Immediately, if you eliminate, then you will get in your required form minus 2. That means this is 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2 cos 2x plus 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 cos 2x minus 2. Right. So look at here, 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2. 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2 means 8 minus 8 by 2, 4 minus 2. Look at cos 2x terms, I am taking common. Minus 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2 cos 2x. Constant is 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is 4. 4 minus 2 will be 2. So required expression is nothing but minus 2 divided by 2. So minus 2 divided by 2 means minus. So required expression you can convert like this. Plus 2. Plus 2. That means this is of form 0 into sine is not there. You write 0 into sine 2x minus 1 into cos 2x plus 2. Look at 2x angle is there here. That's why 0 into sin 2x, A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Same angle is there. That means A is nothing but 0, B is nothing but minus 1, C is nothing but 2. Therefore, minimum value is nothing but C minus C is 2. C minus root of A square plus B square. That means minimum value is nothing but 2 minus 1, 1. Maximum value is nothing but C plus root of A square plus B square. 2 plus 1, 3. Like that, whenever sin square x, cos square x is there, you eliminate that. Then you will get in required form A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Powers must be eliminated. Whenever sin square x, sin cube x, I have told how to eliminate. In the previous chapters, whatever the skills you have learned, you have to apply while simplification. Look at like this. Whatever may be the expression, look at. First you have to simplify and then finally formula. Suppose look at. He has asked to find maximum and minimum values of sine square x plus cos power 4x. Now I will convert this one. Look at. First you have to transform to the form a sine x plus b cos x plus c. Look at how I am transforming. Sine square x plus cos square x into cos square x I am writing. Cos power 4x I am writing like this. Sine square x cos square x into, this is nothing but 1 minus sine square x. I am writing one cos square x as 1 minus sine square x. Now look at it. This into 1 cos square x minus, I am getting sine x cos x whole square. If you multiply, you will get sine x cos x whole square. So now look at, this is 1. Now look at sine x into cos x. Whenever sine x into cos x is there, you write like this. Multiply and divide it by 2. Multiply and divide it by 2. Multiply and divide it by 2. That will become sine 2x. So that will become 1 minus sine 2x by 2 whole square. 1 minus 1 by 4 sine square 2x. Sine square 2x. Now again sine square a is there. I want to eliminate that one. Sine square a is nothing but 1 minus cos 2a. 2 into 2x. Sine square a is nothing but 1 minus cos 2a. 2 into 2x divided by 2. Now if you look at here, multiply with minus 1 by 4. So minus 1 by 8. Minus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8. Multiply with 1 by 4. Plus 1 by 8 cos 4x. So this is nothing but 7 by 8. Now convert it to our form. Look at this expression. Finally, I have simplified like this. Now look at 0 into sine 4x plus 1 by 8 into cos 4x plus 7 by 8. Now a is 0. B is 1 by 8, C is 7 by 8. So what is the minimum value? Minimum value is nothing but C. C means 7 by 8 minus root of A square plus B square. That means 7 by 8 minus 1 by 8. That means 6 divided by 8. That means 3 divided by 4. Minimum value is nothing but 3 divided by 4. Maximum value, just formula, root of a square plus b square. A square plus b square. All the problems will come under that rule. How you will convert, that is important. So 8 by 8. That is what? Therefore, range. Suppose he asks the range. Range means 3 by 4 to 1. 3 by 4 to 1. That means minimum to maximum, or otherwise you will ask like this. Problem sine square x plus cos power 4 belongs to dash. Belongs to dash means range. Belongs to 1 whenever given 3 by 4 comma 1. 3 by 4 comma 1. That is nothing but belongs to means you have to calculate the range. Like that, whatever the expression is given, we have done lot of problems in multiple angles, submultiple angles, compound angles, transformations like that. The expression, by using those techniques, you have to convert into A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Look at next type of questions. Find range of look at 8 cos x into cos of 60 degree minus x cos of 60 degree plus x. Look at this range of 8 cos x cos 60 minus x cos 60 plus x. Now you know the formula of that one. Cos A cos 60 minus A cos 60 plus A. I told the formula. What is that? 1 by 4 cos 3x. So 4 ones, 4 twos. Write the formula. Then you got 2 cos 3x. 2 cos 3x. That means this is nothing but 0 sin 3x. Plus 2 cos 3x plus 0. So A is 0, B is 2, C is 0. So minimum is nothing but 0 minus C minus root of A square plus B square means 4. Minimum value is what? Minus 2. Maximum value is nothing but C minus root of A square, C plus, that means 2. So therefore range is minus 2 comma 2. Like that, this is known, already well known formula in the multiple angles chapter. So that formula you must write. And then this is a form A sin x plus B cos x plus C, or otherwise here only you can tell. Minimum value of cos 3x is what? Minus 1. So 2 into that means minimum value is what? Minus 2. You substitute cos 3x equal to minus 1, you will get minimum value. You take cos 3x equal to 1, you will get maximum value. If single function is there, you can directly tell. Minimum value of this is minus 1. So minimum value is what? Minus 2. Maximum value is what? 2 into 1 maximum value. Because only one cos function is only involved. There you can directly say, or otherwise you can write like this, no problem. Look at next one is find maximum and minimum values of like this. Look at one different mode. Look at 3 sin x plus 4 cos x plus 6. In the denominator will be there. Okay. So in the denominator will be there. But you know how to calculate for this one. One by that he is asking. Look at. So this is 1 by, this is 1 by this one. So here 1 by this one means when this 1 by this reciprocal will be maximum. When the denominator is minimum, 1 by this will be maximum. Correct or not? Look at, when the denominator is minimum, this reciprocal will be maximum. when the denominator is maximum, reciprocal will be what? Minimum. That means what you have to do is minimum value equal to 1 divided by maximum value of this. Maximum value of 3 sin x plus 4 cos x plus 6. Look at it. If the denominator is maximum, then this reciprocal will be minimum. That's why whenever minimum value you want to calculate, 1 by, in the denominator whatever it is there, you calculate maximum value of that. If you are calculating minimum value, in the denominator you write maximum value. If you are calculating maximum value, then in the denominator you write minimum value. Because in the denominator if it is maximum, then it will become minimum. So you know how to calculate this one. A is what? 3. B is what? 4. C is what? 6. Right? So 1 divided by. What is the formula for this one? C plus root of A square plus B square. C plus root of 9 plus 16. That means 1 by 6 plus 25 is 5. So minimum value of this one is 1 by 11. 1 by 11, like that. Maximum value, just simple, whenever you are calculating maximum value, write minimum value of 1 by minimum value of plus 6, right? What is minimum value? You can easily calculate. 1 divided by, again, c minus root of A square plus B square, 1 by 6 minus 5, that is 1 by 1. Maximum value is what? 1. Therefore, range, suppose if he asks, range is nothing but minimum value is 1 by 11, maximum value is 1, like that. Whenever 1 by an expression is there, for this 1 by, minimum value is nothing but This divided by denominator maximum value, right? This value you can calculate. What is the maximum value of that?
వెనక్కు వచ్చేసి వెయిట్ ఫర్ 2 మినిట్స్ అమ్మ, పవర్ ఆఫ్ ఈజ్ హియర్. ఇప్పుడు చెప్పు, వెయిట్ ఫర్ 2 మినిట్స్ అమ్మ, పవర్ ఆఫ్. ఇన్ 5 మినిట్స్ ఇట్ విల్ కమ్. వెయిట్. Wait for 5 minutes, someone. Power off is here. Oh, okay, number power came. Just wait for 2 minutes. Wi-Fi will be coming. Well, like that, Amma, look at. So minimum value is nothing but if 1 by is given, if in the denominator it is there, if minimum value you are calculating, 1 by maximum value of denominator. If maximum value you are calculating, 1 by minimum value of denominator. Like that, the same expression will be in the denominator. Suppose, let us take an example. Find. Minimum. And maximum values of. Minimum and maximum values of, suppose take another example, 1 by 5 plus 4 sine 2x. Look at that, like this. Okay, so therefore, minimum value equal to 1 by maximum value of 5 plus 4 sine 2x. Right? So minimum value of this is nothing but 1 by maximum value of this. Now here A is what? 4. B is what? Cos 2x is not there. 0. C is what? 5. Directly in the denominator write the formula. 1 divided by, look at, C 5 minus root of A square plus B square. A square means 16 plus. That means 1 by 5 minus 4, 1. 1 by 1 means 1. So minimum value of this is nothing but 1. Look at, suppose you want to calculate maximum value. Nothing but 1 by minimum value of 5 plus 4 sine 2x. 4 sine 2x. That means 1 by minimum value is nothing but C minus root of A square plus B square. 16 plus. Here plus 1 by 9. So minimum is nothing but 1 by 9. Here minus. So root of 16 plus 0. 1 by 5 minus 4. Maximum value is what? 1. Minimum value is 1 by 9. Maximum value is 1. Therefore range is nothing but minimum to maximum. 1 by 9 to 1. Like that, simple. In the previous problems, A sin x plus B cos x plus C is in the numerator. For these type of problems, it will be in the denominator. Whenever it is in the denominator, if you are calculating minimum value,
then minimum value is nothing but 1 divided by maximum value of that. Maximum value is nothing but 1 divided by minimum value of that. So let us take an example. Suppose you need to calculate minimum and maximum values of 5 divided by, look at, 13 cos square x plus 12 sin x cos x minus 3 sin square x. Suppose you need to calculate the minimum and maximum values of this 5 divided by 13 cos square x plus 12 sin x cos x minus 3 sin square x. So look at now. This is not in direct form. First, we will simplify this expression such that in the denominator, a sin x plus b cos x plus c is there. First, simplify this. 5 divided by cos square x can be written as, cos square x can be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2. I am eliminating this cos square, 1 plus cos 2x by 2. As you are writing in angle, this is nothing but 6 into 2 sin x cos x. That means 6 sin 2x minus 3 into sin square x. 1 minus cos 2x divided by 2. Cos 2x divided by 2. Now here in the denominator, take 2 LCM, 5 divided by, take 2 LCM. So, 2 is the LCM here. Now, this is 13 cos 2x plus 2 is the LCM, 12 sin 2x. minus 3 plus 3 cos 2x, right? So now here 5 is there. Now 2 will come up, 10 divided by. Now given expression is nothing but 10 divided by sin 2x term is there, 12 sin 2x. Right? 12 sin 2x. Now 13 cos 2x plus 3 cos 2x. So 16 cos 2x. Then 13 minus 3, this is nothing but 10. Now convert it. Now you can strike off 2 also. Take 2 common in the denominator, 5 divided by, look at. I have taken 2 common and cancelled. Now, this expression is same as this one. First, you have to convert whatever in the denominator is there. A sin x plus b cos x plus this given one and this one is same. That means for calculating this, you know the formula. Now, minimum value. Look at, I am calculating. Minimum value. is nothing but 5 constant. This is 5 divided by maximum value of this. Maximum value of this. Right? So 5 divided by 5 divided by what is the maximum value here? A is 6, B is 8, C is 5. So, right? So, maximum value is nothing but 5 plus root of A square plus B square, 36 plus 64. 5 divided by 5 plus root of 110. So 5 divided by 15, that is nothing but 1 by 3. That is the minimum value. Maximum value only I have asked minimum 5. In the IIT it was asked only maximum value. Like this, it is asked in IIT. Find minimum positive value. Minimum positive value of 5 divided by this one. So, minimum positive value means this only. What is that answer? 1 by 3. Like this, it is asked in IIT. This problem itself is asked in IIT. He has asked, find minimum positive value of 5 divided by this one. Minimum is what? 1 by 3. Like that it is asked in IIT. Like that whenever the denominator is there, in the previous two problems, I have given it directly. A sin x plus B cos x plus C. If it is not given directly, you have to convert that into denominator into A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Like that, number of expressions will be there by using multiple angles formulae, transformation formulae, and whatever the strategies you have learned, the trigonometric expression must be converted into A sin x plus B cos x plus C. Okay, now like that. Next, look at coming to the next concept. Till here, basics are there now. In the functions chapter, again, I will extend this. Till here, now in syllabus, till here it is there. Right? Now, coming to the next concept. Periods of trigonometric functions. Now in periods also basics are there now in syllabus. Okay. Again in functions you will have extension of this one again. Periods of trigonometric functions. What is meant by period is? A function. Listen carefully. In the definition itself, number of problems will solve. A function f of x is said to be a periodic function. A periodic function having period. Period P if there exists a positive value a positive value p such that look at the definition I will explain. X plus p equal to f of x. P is greater than 0. P is greater than 0. Then here the least positive value. Of p, the least positive value of p is called period or fundamental period. Fundamental period of f of x. Look at here, simply, look at, I will explain this definition. Simply, there is a function. Function is nothing but sin x. Function means nothing is there, anything in x. Suppose sin x is there, that is called one function, f of x. In terms of x is there, that is nothing but f of x. So suppose a function is there, it is said to be a periodic function having period p. If there exists a positive value of p such that, look at here, suppose let us take f of x equal to sin x. Suppose this sin x is denoted by f of x. That means here f of pi by 6 means sin pi by 6. Here whatever you write x, here you write x. That is called a function. Let us say f of x equal to sin x. Replace both sides x equal to, suppose let us say x plus 2 pi. Suppose here I am replacing x equal to x plus 2 pi. That means sine of x plus 2 pi. Sine of x, just in place of x, suppose f of pi by 6. Look at f of pi by 6 means sine pi by 6. In place of x, you can replace anything. This is 1 by 2. Like that, in place of x, I have replaced x plus 2 pi. That means this is nothing but sine of x plus 2 pi. This is sine of 360 plus x. Sine of 360 plus x means sine x, because it is in first quadrant. Because this is in first quadrant. That means again you got f of x. Again you got f of x. That means in this function, if you replace x by x plus 2 pi, then again you are getting f of x. Like that, if you get f of x again, this is called p. Look at. That means f of x plus p equal to f of x. What is p? This is called period. This is called period of sine x. Look at. You can ask why I have to replace x by x plus 2 pi only. Suppose you replace, look at here. Suppose if you replace x equal to x plus pi, let us say, right? X equal to x plus pi. Suppose you are calculating f of x plus pi. That means what? Sine of x plus pi. Sine of x plus pi. Sine of x plus pi means minus sine x. This is not equal to, again you won't get sine x. Again you won't get sine x. You have to replace x by x plus such that you will again get sine x only. You will again get f of x only, but you are getting minus sin x here. So therefore, this p is not period. This p is not period. Whenever you are replacing x by x plus something, positive quantity, again you are getting f of x, means that positive quantity whatever is there, that is called period. Suppose if you are replacing x equal, look at here. If you are replacing x plus 4 pi, let us say, x equal to x plus 4 pi, look at f of x plus 4 pi, what you will get? Sine of x plus 4 pi. X plus 4 pi means again first quadrant, this also you will get sine x. This also you will get sine x. That means you got f of x plus p equal to, this is again f of x, same you got na sine x. So f of x plus p equal to f of x. Here p is what? 4 pi. P. Here p is what? 4 pi. Here p what you will get? 2 pi. That means if you replace x by x plus 2 pi, you will get f of x. If you replace x by x plus 4 pi, you will get f of x. So this is also p value. Least value is what? Least value is what? 2 pi only. Least value. Least value is what? Least value. The least positive value of p. Least positive value. Least positive value of p is nothing but 2 pi. 2 means 2 into 3.147. 2 pi. 4 into 3.147. What is the least value? 2 pi. This is called period. Or fundamental period. Fundamental period. Okay, now, like that, f of, if you replace x by x plus 2 pi, then again you will get sin x. If you replace x by x plus 4 pi, again you will get sin x. But what is the least value? Least value of p is 2 pi. That's why period of sin x is 2 pi. Therefore, we will say that period. Period of sin x is 2 pi. 2 pi. Period of sin x equal to 2 pi. Right? Because if period are not, you have to check, means take this as f of x. What is the reason? As f of x equal to sin x. If this is period or not, you have to check, means replace x by x plus p. Look at, this is p. Whenever period, whenever a number is given, it is period or not, you have to check, means you have to calculate f of x plus p. You have to calculate f of x plus p. Take that as 2 pi. If you calculate f of x plus p, x plus 2 pi. F of x plus 2 pi. That means f of x plus 2 pi is nothing but sine of x plus 2 pi. That is nothing but sine x. Sine x. That means you have to get f of x. That means if this is f of x and this is p, if you calculate f of x plus p, then you are getting again f of x. Then p is called period. That is the least positive value. If p equal to 4 pi taken also, you will get f of x only. But least value is what? Least value is nothing but 2 pi. Least value is nothing but 2 pi. Problems can be done in this manner. Look at, suppose for example, any function it is given, look at. Suppose f of x equal to sine x plus cos x. Sine x plus cos x, look at. I will tell again, what is period of cos x tan x like that. The basic fundamental is f of x equals sin x plus cos x given. Period of f of x is number 1, pi by 4, number 2, pi by 2, number 3, pi, number 4, 2 pi. Like this it is given. Like this it is given. Suppose let us take. Again we will come into fundamentals. Now till here I told period of sin x is 2 pi. Right? Remember that. Now look at here. Now you can check whether pi by 4 is a period or not. First option correct or not you check. P equal to pi by 4. Let us say this is the period, that is P. P equal to pi by 4. Now I have to calculate f of x plus p. If this is the period f of x plus p, I have to get f of x again. That means f of x plus p is nothing but f of x plus pi by 4. Let us take this as p. If it is correct, if I am calculating this one, then I have to get f of x. That means look at sine of x plus pi by 4 plus cos of x plus pi by 4 you will get. You are not getting f of x because sine of x plus pi by 4, it cannot be written as sine x. Can it be written as sine x? No. Right? So that's why you won't get f of x. This plus this you won't get f of x. That means therefore it is not period. Pi by 4 is not period. Right? First option gone. Next, second. Suppose let us take P equal to pi. Let us say period is this one. That means I am calculating f of x plus p. What I have to get f of x? That means f of x plus pi by 2. F of x plus pi by 2. F of x plus pi by 2. That means f of x plus pi by 2 means in place of x plus pi by 2 plus cos of x plus pi by 2. So sine of 90 plus x sum cos x. Cos of 90 plus x sum minus sine x. Is you getting f of x? No, not equal to f of x. Not equal to f of x. Therefore, pi by 2 is not period. So this is wrong, this is wrong. Now take p equal to pi. Now take t equal to pi. P equal to pi. Suppose let us say this is the period. Then calculate f of x plus p. F of x plus pi. Now look at, I am replacing x by x plus pi. Sine of x plus pi plus cos of x plus pi. Sine of pi plus x, 180 plus x means minus sine x, minus cos x. Are you getting f of x? No. Not equal to f of x. Therefore, pi is not period. So this is also wrong. Right? Number 4. For p equal to 2 pi, let us say p equal to 2 pi. Let us say p equal to 2 pi. Now I am calculating f of x plus p. This is nothing but f of x plus 2 pi. F of x plus 2 pi means sine of x plus 2 pi plus cos of x plus 2 pi. Sine of x plus 2 pi plus cos of x plus 2 pi. Sine of 360 plus theta first quadrant. This is sine x plus cos x. So what is that? This is f of x. So that means you got f of x plus 2 pi equal to f of x. That means 2 pi is the period. Therefore, 2 pi is period. So answer is what? 2 pi. Answer is what? 2 pi. Like that. Like that, whenever f of x is given, 4 answers is given. You can check whether a quantity is period or not. Take that p equal to pi by 4. And then calculate f of x plus p. This is the one. If you got f of x, then that is the period. Here you won't got. So you are not getting. That's why it is not period. Pi by 2. F of x plus p calculated. You are not getting f of x. So this is not period. P equal to pi taken. F of x plus p, I got what? Not equal to f of x. So this is not period. Now 2 pi taken, f of x plus p calculated, what you got f of x. Suppose another answer is given like this. Suppose 4 pi is also given. Let us take the fifth option also. Let us take. Suppose two answers you got pi. Let us take p equal to 4 pi. P equal to 4 pi. F of x plus p. That means f of x plus 4 pi. That means sine of x plus 4 pi plus cos of x plus 4 pi. Right? So what you will get, this is also first quadrant. 4 pi means 2 rotations plus x. First quadrant, this is you will get sine x. This is you will get cos x. This is you will get cos x. So you are getting f of x for this also. For this also. Therefore, p equal to 4 pi is also period. Now, how many answers you got? This and this you got. That means out of these two, if you are getting two answers, least positive value. Least value of p. Least value of p is what? 2 pi. This is called period. 2 pi. Suppose you are getting for two values of p f of x. Then period is the least positive value. Least positive value of p. That is what? 2 pi. Even for 4 pi also you are getting. Right, but the least value is what? 2 pi. That is the answer. That is called fundamental period or period. Least value we have to take for the period. Like that for any function, suppose look at sine x is there. Sine x. If you take p equal to 2 pi, f of x plus p is what? F of x plus 2 pi, that is f of x. If you take p equal to 4 pi, f of x plus 4 pi is what? Sine of x plus 4 pi. Again, you are getting sine x only. But the least value is what? 2 pi. For sine x, period is what? 2 pi. Like that, for any function, if in the exam given and you have to calculate the period, take the options. Okay, now for everything, there won't be any formula. Take the options. First option, take it as p and calculate f of x plus p. If you are getting f of x, then list down that. Then second option, then third option, then fourth option. Suppose you are getting three options correct. Out of that, least value is nothing but the period. Right? Suppose take another example. F of x equal to. After telling these two examples, I will come into the topic again. Modulus sin x plus modulus cos x. Modulus means positive. Positive. Modulus means always inside negative is there, it will become positive. Period. Period of f of x is number 1. Pi by 2. Number 2, pi. Number 3, 2 pi. Number 4, 4 pi. Like that given. Like that given. Now let us take number first option. P equal to pi by 2. P p equal to pi by 2. That means f of, I am taking f of, I am calculating f of x plus p. X plus pi by 2. F of x plus pi by 2. Look at modulus of sine of x plus pi by 2 plus modulus of cos of x plus pi by 2. Modulus. So if you look at here, modulus of sine of 90 plus x. Sine of 90 plus x means you will get cos x plus modulus of cos of 90 plus x, second quadrant, minus sin x. Minus sin x. If inside modulus negative is there, it will become positive. Plus modulus, if inside negative is there, then you will get positive only. Modulus sin x. What you got? F of x, what is given? The same you got. This only. That means this is nothing but f of x. This is nothing but f of x. Therefore, pi by 2 is, for pi by 2, you got f of x. Suppose if you take pi, here least value means, if even if you get also, this is the answer only. Suppose look at f of x plus pi. P equal to pi, let us say second option. P equal to pi. I am calculating f of x plus p. This is nothing but f of x plus pi. F of x plus pi. Replace here x plus pi. Sine of x plus pi plus modulus cos of x plus pi. So now look at here, sine of 180 plus x, that means minus sine x. Third quadrant term. Cos of 180 plus x minus cos x. So what you are getting, this is modulus sine x plus modulus cos x. Minus means positive you will get. So this is nothing but f of x. So even for pi also you got. That means least value is what? This is the answer. Even for 2 pi you will get. Even for 4 pi you will get. So out of this, whatever you are getting f of x, among that least value is what? Pi by 2. Therefore, period is nothing but pi by 2. Like that, whenever the function is given, a typical function, and the answers are given, take first option p. Calculate f of x plus p. If you get f of x, for start from the least, okay, now pi by 2 is least. If you are getting that only, that is the answer. No need to check other options. Okay, now if you are not getting, next least one, then next least one. So suppose 2 or 3 answers you got, among that choose least one, that is the period. That is the basic of this chapter. F of x plus p equal to f of x, the least positive value of p you will get is called period or fundamental period of f of x. Now coming to the point, now I will list down function f of x period. Now sine x. Period is 2pi. Period is 2pi. Already told. F of x plus 2pi is nothing but f of x you will get again. Similarly, cos x 2pi. Look at, if this is f of x. F of x plus 2pi is what? F of x. Look at equation I am writing. Equation. You will get f of x plus 2pi is nothing but f of x. Here also if you replace x plus 2pi, then you will get f of x only. Of course for 4pi also you will get, but the least value you will get is 2pi. You won't get for pi, because cos of x plus pi is what? Minus cos x. You won't get f of x. suppose tan x is there, tan x function period is pi, because f of x plus pi is nothing but f of x. Look at here, tan of x plus pi is what? Tan x, because third quadrant. Tan of x plus 2 pi also you will get tan x only, but least value is what? Pi, that is the period. Period is denoted by pm, period is denoted by p. For cot x, period is pi. For cot x, period is pi, because if you replay, if you calculate f of x plus pi, you will get f of x. So suppose let us say secant x, for this also period is 2 pi. F of x plus 2 pi is nothing but f of x. Suppose cosecant x, period is 2 pi, because you will get f of x plus 2 pi equal to f of x. Like this. Basic fundamental functions these are. Except tan x and cot x. Except tan x and cot x. For everything period is what? 2 pi. Only tan x and cot x will have pi. The remaining trigonometric functions will have period 2 pi. Question is given means answers will be there like that. You take first option p and then calculate f of x plus p. If you are getting f of x, then that is the period. Out of those four, choose the least positive value. If you are getting more than two values, then choose the least one. That is the way of doing the question. Now, basic fundamental periods these are. Suppose next list is, look at, this is first list, next, function period, look at. Suppose sin x period is 2 pi, suppose sin of ax plus b is there, then what you have to do is, sin x period is what? 2 pi divided by modulus a, Here suppose take an example, sin of 2x plus 3 is there, period means period equal to pm, period equal to p, that is nothing but for sine function period is what? If x is there, directly 2 pi, right? If 2x plus 3 is there, x coefficient here a is what? 2, modulus 2. That means period is, modulus 2 means always positive, that means period is pi. For sin 2x plus 3, period is pi, because look at why period is pi. Look at, suppose this is f of x, this is f of x. Look at p is period or not. Let us take p equal to pi. You got pi now. Is this period or not? I will check. Look at, I am calculating f of x plus p. What I will get? F of x plus pi. Suppose I am calculating f of x plus pi. That means sin of 2 into, in place of x you replace x plus pi, f of x plus pi means wherever x is there you put x plus pi. That means what I am getting? Look at, sin of 2 pi plus 2x plus 3, that I am getting. Sin of 2 pi plus theta, sin of 360 plus theta. Sin of 360 plus theta means what? Sin theta. Theta is 2x plus 3. So that, for that I am getting what? F of x. Therefore period is what? Pi. Like that, whenever sin of ax plus b is there, you write 2 pi divided by sin period 2 pi divided by modulus of x coefficient. Here before x what is there? A. 2 pi divided by modulus a, like that. Suppose first one, this is the one, second one. Second one. Cos of AX plus B. Cos of AX plus B same. 2 pi divided by modulus A. Cos period is 2 pi divided by before X. Whatever it is, then divide by modulus A. Suppose look at cos of 3x. Cos of 3x. Period is what? P equals to 2 pi divided by 3. 2 pi divided by 3. This is 120 degree period. 2 into 60 means what? 120 degree. Like that, cos 3x. P A is what? 3. 2 pi divided by modulus 3 means 3. Like that, for cos AX plus B, 2 pi divided by modulus A. Similarly, for tan AX plus B, what is for tan? Pi divided by modulus A. Pi divided by modulus A. Suppose take an example. Tan of minus 3x plus 4. Tan of minus 3x plus 4. Now A is what here? Minus 3. So therefore, period is pi by modulus of minus 3. Modulus of minus 3 means it will become positive. Pi divided by 3. Like that, tan of AX plus B. Just fundamental period of tan X divided by modulus A. Suppose, for cot of AX plus B, what is the period? Similarly, pi divided by modulus A. Similarly, for secant amount. Secant is nothing but again 2 pi divided by modulus A. Look at cosecant. Cosecant of AX plus B. Cosecant of AX plus B is nothing but 2 pi divided by modulus A. Suppose example, you take example. Suppose example, right? So suppose it is like this. Cosecant of pi x by 2. Cosecant of pi x by 2. So you have to find the period of that one. So A is what here? A is nothing but before x, whatever it is there, that is A. A is pi by 2. Therefore, period P is nothing but 2 pi divided by modulus pi by 2. So that is positive quantity only, pi by 2. Pi pi cancel, period is what? 4. Period of cosecant pi x by 2 is 4. Like that. Now we have known original functions. Sin x, cos x, tan x, cot x. Basic functions. Right? Next set is what? Sin of ax plus b, cos of ax plus b, tan of ax plus b. Just previous period divided by modulus A, x coefficient, like these type of functions. Okay. Suppose one function is like this. Look at. If more than one function is there, one function is involved. If more than one function is involved, then period equal to LCM of periods. Look at here. Periods of all functions. Look at this point. Suppose I will take an example. Look at. That means if in the given one, here only one cos, one tan, like that, more than one function is involved, then period of that function is LCM of periods of all functions. Suppose take an example. With example, I will explain. Look at. Find the period of. Look at. I am taking like this. Find the period finding the period of number one. Number one. Suppose take an example 2 sine pi x by 2, 2 sine pi x by 2 minus 3 cos pi x by 3. It is like this. 2 sine pi x by 2 minus 3 cos pi x by 3 plus 2 tan pi x by 4. Like this. How many functions are involved? Sine function is there, cos function is there, tan function is there. Then in this, there are 3 functions. Like that, if more than one function is there, how to calculate period? Look at how to calculate period. Take whatever sine is there, you take sine, first function, number 1. Sine pi x by 2. Sine pi x by 2. Constant will have no value because period is involved with x. Constant you don't take, only this function you take. Right? This. Now let us say period is P1. Now let us say period is P1. For this you can calculate now. What is the period for sine ax? 2 pi divided by modulus a. 2 pi divided by modulus a. What is a here? Before x, what is there? Pi by 2. 2 pi divided by modulus pi by 2. That means this pi and this pi will get cancelled. So period is what? For the first function, P1 is the period 4. Take second function. Only cos, remaining constant. Only this one. P2. Let us say P2, period. Now for cos AX plus B, period is what? 2 pi divided by modulus A. 2 pi divided by modulus A. 2 pi. 2 pi divided by modulus A means here before x, whatever it is there, that is A. 2 pi divided by pi by 3, that means 6. Period is what? 6 for second function. Similarly, third function you take. Tan pi x by 4. Period. This is tan of ax plus b. What is the formula? Pi divided by modulus a. Pi divided by modulus pi by 4. Modulus pi by 4 means pi will get cancelled. So now, for the three functions, I have calculated period separately. Therefore, for this complete function, therefore, period of given function equal to, just you take the LCM, LCM of P1, P2, P3. That is the required period. So that means LCM of 4 pi divided, right? So 4, 6, 4. This is what LCM, 24. This is what LCM is what? 24. So LCM is 24. That is the required period. You take the LCM, 4, 6, 4. LCM is what? 24. That means period of the given function is nothing but 24. Like that, if in the given function more than one function is involved, take one by one and then periods, all the periods by using the previous formula, and then after that take LCM of all the periods, then you will get the required answer. That is the one, right? That is how to calculate the period if a function contains more than one. Only sine is there means direct formula. Sine, cos, tan, like that is there. For that, calculate the functions and then take the LCM. That will be the required period. That will be the required period. Look at how the questions will be asked. Look at how the questions will be asked. period of sine power 4x plus cos power 4x is number 1, pi by 4 number 2, pi number 3, 2 pi number 4, pi by 2, number 4, pi by 2. This problem I will do it in two ways. Look at, in the examination you can do in any method. Look at, first option I want to check from the options, checking from the options whether this is period or not. Suppose take p equal to pi by 4, first one, correct or not. So I will take the function as f of x, given one take f of x, given one take f of x, take f of x. Now I will calculate f of x plus p. Period means what? If you calculate f of x plus p, you have to get f of x. If this is correct, I will calculate this one. Look at f of x plus pi by 4. F of x plus pi by 4 is what? Don't go away, Emma. Important points are going on. Just f of x plus pi by 4 means just replace x plus pi by 4. Now after writing, you will easily get, you won't get f of x. How you will get this f of x? Not. So not equal to f of x. So this is wrong. How you will get f of x? You won't get sine power 4x. If you further simplify also, you won't get. That means you will not get f of x. That means this is not the period. Eliminate that. So next, if you calculate f of x plus pi, second option, let us take p equal to pi. Now I am calculating f of x plus p. Now I am calculating f of x plus pi. So that means replace x by x plus pi. That means sine of x plus pi whole power 4 plus cos of x plus pi whole power 4. So sine of 180 plus theta, that means minus sine, this is minus cos. So that means this is again minus 1 whole power 4 is 1. What you are getting? This you are getting f of x. So this option I am getting. But again, least value must be there. Least value. You have to check other options also. You have to check other options also. This I am succeeded. F of x plus p equal to f of x I got, but may not be this answer. Least value is nothing but period. That means third option you take. Third option. Third option is 2 pi you take. F of x plus p is nothing but f of x plus 2 pi. This is nothing but sine power 4 x plus 2 pi plus cos power 4. So obviously 360 plus x, you will get same sine power 4x plus. So this is nothing but f of x only. So for this also I got the answer. 3 is also correct. 3 is also correct. That means f of x plus p equal to f of x. Fourth option I am taking. Follow carefully. It is easy to solve the problem in periodicity. F of p is pi by 2. Now I am taking f of x plus p. F of x plus pi by 2. Suppose I am calculating f of x plus pi by 2. Look at what I will get. Sine of x plus pi by 2 whole to the power 4. In place of x, you replace x plus pi by 2 plus cos of x plus pi by 2 whole to the power 4. What is sine of 90 plus theta? sine of 90 plus theta is nothing but cos theta. This is cos power 4x. Cos of 90 plus theta minus sine x whole power 4. That means this will become sine power 4x. What I am getting? Again, I am getting f of x only. Now, this is also correct. Now, what is the period? Out of pi by 2, 2 pi pi. What is the least value? Pi by 2. That you have to mark. Least value is nothing but pi by 2. Like that, take all the options. Take that p and then calculate f of x plus p. And then out of 4, select where you got f of x plus p equal to f of x. Out of those, select least value. That is nothing but the period. For sine x, sine of x plus 2 pi you got sine x. Sine of x plus 4 pi you got sine x. But period, whatever you are telling, least value 2 pi. Like that, for this, this is the least value. Like that, from the option. Always do the period problems from the options. It will be easy. Right? Suppose, original method I will tell, okay. How to do without doing like this, directly. Direct method. Direct method means, look at, convert this into base functions. Eliminating all 4s and cubes, convert into basic function. After eliminating all the cubes and 4s, look at how I am doing the problem. In the basic method. In the basic method I am doing, look at, this I am writing sine square x whole square plus cos square x whole square. Look at sine square x whole square plus cos square x whole square. This is a square plus b square. I am writing a plus b whole square minus 2ab. A square plus b square is there. That means I am writing like this. Sine square x plus cos square x whole square minus 2 sine square x cos square x. I am writing like this. Another method of doing is this. Look at sine square x plus cos square x whole square is what? 1. 1 minus 2 into I am writing. This I am writing. Sine x cos x whole square. Sine x cos x whole square. Here itself I am multiplying and dividing. That means 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 into. This is sine 2x. By 2 whole square. That means 1 minus 2 into 1 by 4, 1 by 2 sine square 2x. Now this sine square 2x also I want to eliminate. Powers must not be there. In basic functions you have to convert. 1 minus 1 by 2 into, look at, this is sine square a is nothing but 1 minus cos 2a divided by 2. 1 minus cos 2a divided by 2. Now multiply with 1 by 2. We will get 1 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 cos 4x. Now this is 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4 cos 4x. So now look at, this is equal to this one. In this, how many functions are there? Except constants, only function is there. Period. Of cos 4x. Cos 4x, direct basic formula. 2 pi divided by modulus a. That means 2 pi divided by 4. What is that? Pi by 2. 2 pi divided by 4. What is that? Pi by 2. That is the answer. Like that, whenever you are doing the period, eliminate all the powers and bring it to the basic function. So this is remaining are constants. Constant, there won't be any effect. Period is related with what? X. So this is the function, is there only one function. That is nothing but 2 pi divided by modulus 4, 2 pi by 4, that is pi by 2. Two methods of doing amma in the exam. F of x is given, period he is asking. Look at the options. First option, take it as p and calculate f of x plus p. If you are not getting f of x, it is not period. If you are getting two answers f of x, then out of those least possible value you take, that is called period. Okay, now so all of you share your video. I want to interact with you. So till here syllabus is there. Till here syllabus for the exam. Okay, now. So from Monday onwards, the complete All India China batch program will be same.